I've been selling my soul, working all day, overtime hours for bullshit pay, so I can sit out here and waste my life away, drag back home and drown my troubles away. It's a damn shame what the world's gotten to for people like me, people like you. Wish I could just wake up and it not be true, but it is. Oh, it is living in the new world with an whole soul. These rich men know the rich men, Lord knows it all. Just wanna have total control. Wanna know what you think, wanna know what you do. And they don't think you know, but I know that you do. Cause your dollar ain't shit, and it's taxed to no end.
There and welcome to this channel. We are reacting to Oliver Anthony Richman North, Rich of Richmond, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna pretend I haven't heard of this guy because he blew the hell up. I believe he even reached the Billboard 100. This has 64 million views in just in a month, 1 month, 64 million views, beating out most mainstream popular pop stars. I don't even know if someone like Beyonce can pull in 64 million views in 1 month. I have heard a bit of this song, but I haven't heard the whole thing, and I haven't heard it in a long time. I just kind of, when it first came out and I see him blow up and he was all over Twitter. And the thing that I like about this dude, besides his musical talent, and his rugged looks, I love the contrast between the beard and the hair color. If it's not dyed, I think that's a specific name for that when you have a different hair color for your beard than your hair. But the thing that I like about him is when he first came out, all the Republicans and all the conservatives and all the Trumpers were all like, yes, he's ours, he's a part of our army, he's on our team because we are just so tribalist and that's the only thing we fucking care about. He was like, no, like actually this was like anti-politics, anti-politicians, anti-government, like this had nothing to do with conservatism or right-wing or Republican. This has nothing to do with supporting a candidate. This song was meant for your average guy and gal. This was meant for your minimum wage, working class, Midwestern, mom and dad, pop and mom, kids, and just trying to make it through. This was for your everyday person, across the board, just for your average American and even beyond that. This was supposed to bring us together. Hey, you're not alone and we can all relate. We're all struggling here and everyone kind of feels it. Everyone feels on edge, and I felt it when I was back in the States. By the way, I'm back overseas. If you're coming from my other channel, Mika Reacts to Reviews, I'm in Nepal at the moment. I spent 6 months in America, and yeah, the energy there, not for me. In your average, if not almost every politician and almost every political talking head on YouTube, CNN, or Fox News, they can't relate to you. They don't relate to the average Joe, the average Jane. They don't relate to the average American, the average citizen, the working class person. They don't relate to you. They don't have your lived experience. They might have never had your lived experience, and they never will. So how can they help you when they don't even know what you're experiencing, and they probably don't even have the empathy levels to try to understand what you're experiencing? So the fact that everyone's depending on the politics and depending on government, the fact that everyone's hanging on the fucking teeth, a ball sack of every fucking political talking head on YouTube or mainstream media, is crazy because they probably don't really give a fuck about you or care about you. This song wasn't for them. This song wasn't to promote that. This song wasn't to uplift a political idea. Yes, he seems like a red-blooded American that loves his God and loves his country and loves his dogs, but that doesn't mean that he's like waving a sort of flag. And I love that about that, because I'm so sick of tribalism and I'm so sick of politicians and political talking heads trying to like grab whatever celebrity that they can get because they're trying to build up their fucking political army. Not for you, but for their own good, right? So that's the thing that I liked about this dude. I love the emotion and the conviction in his voice whether it's something he's experienced, whether it's something he can relate to, or whether it's something he's experienced before. I love that about him. I love the simplicity of the video, but the soulfulness of the song, and I love the tinginess of the guitar. I'm not a musical technician, so I cannot break down why the guitar is so great. I don't really know what kind of guitar that is, but I love the sound of the guitar. We are gonna get back into the song.
Politicians look out for miners, and not just miners on an island somewhere. Lord, we got folks in the street, ain't got nothing to eat, and the obese milk and welfare. God, if you're 5'3" and you're 300 pounds, taxes ought not to pay for your bags of fudge rounds. Young men are putting themselves 6 feet in the ground, 'cause all this damn country does is keep on kicking them down. Lord, it's a damn shame what the world's gotten to for people like me, people like you. Wish I could just wake up and it not be true, but it is. Oh, it is. Living in the new world with an whole soul. These rich men know the rich men. Lord knows they all just wanna have total control. Wanna know what you think, wanna know what you do, and they don't think you know, but I know that you do. 'Cause your dollar ain't shit, and it's taxed to no end. 'Cause the rich men know the rich men.
Alright, stopping it there before we get to the last bit. He talked a little bit about the obesity crisis in America that is now just, I guess, body positivity, that's what we're calling it today. And sort of sucking people who do take advantage of the welfare system. I have to say, when I went back to the States, and I haven't gone back to the States in 8 years, I was really flabbergasted and astonished, like, how unhealthy everybody was. Like, from the babies to the adults, you know, like, I worked in a shop and I saw what people were buying, and it was just poison and fake food and artificial this and artificial that, like not a fucking fresh produce or piece of meat and or eggs or milk, like real food in the basket. And seeing parents yell at their kids who's like 5 because he's bouncing off the walls, but you're also feeding him poison. It's like getting someone high or giving someone drugs and then getting mad that they're high. Like, you're feeding your child chemical poison, but you're mad that they're not behaving correctly because you're just injected artificial shit into the bloodstream, basically. Like, the waistline expansion, like, everything was so, just everyone was so freaking unhealthy, and it's so sad. And if people don't realize that the welfare system and food stamp system was never meant to just enable you to buy whatever junk that you're buying now. It was like a nutrition thing. It was meant to make sure you're getting a well-rounded nutritional bill. And a lot of these junk food companies went out and lobbied to make sure you can buy junk food also with your food stamps and also with your welfare. It was never meant for that. It didn't start off like that. It was to make sure your kids can get bananas, apples, eggs, milk, and chicken and beef. That's what it was meant for. It wasn't meant so you can buy like every type of Dorito there is. But the lobbyists of these junk food companies said, no, you shouldn't be able to do that. And it's a whole fucking story behind that, because they want you sick, they want you ill, they want to control what you're thinking, they want to control how you're feeling. And one of the ways to do that is through nutrition. Google it. There's too much information out there for people still to be feeding their kids junk food. There's too much nutritional facts out there for you to still be killing yourself with these awful fucking shit you're putting in your body. You're basically letting them win. Right? And he said, you want to control what you think, they want to control what you do, and I'm going to control what you feel and stuff like that. And we know that through social media, through echo chambers, through mainstream news media, through movies, through music, low vibrational, low IQ bullshit that keeps you distracted and dumbed down. But you have to take some accountability and responsibility for yourself. We're going to continue the song because now I'm rambling. I got really heated. Apologies. Let's get back into it.
I've been selling my soul, working all day, overtime hours for bullshit pay.
All right, guys, that was Oliver Anthony. I love this song, and I love that he is trying to bring people together with a message that I think, or frustration I think, that we all can feel. And if you don't like the fact that I kind of rant a little bit, I just want to let you know, if you're new to this channel, I'm not the type of reactor who's going to just bob my head and say bars, tight, lit, and that's it. I like to break down the context and the essence of the songs, if there's any context and essence to be broke down. If you don't like that, that's fine. You don't have to watch this channel. Please just go to the original and show this guy some love. And if you do like that, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'm trying to get this channel monetized as quickly as possible. You guys have been on YouTube long enough, you know how this works. Push it through the algorithm by like, commenting, and subscribing. Tell me what you think of the song, if you can relate to the song, if you love the guy. I love the fact that he's finding a lot of success right now, and I wish him more continued success.
Working all day, overtime hours, for bullshit pay, so I can sit out here and